It's the video that's gone viral. A national restaurant chain is in the spotlight tonight after a Volusia County employee exposes trays of food next to the dumpster.
So what's going on here? WESH 2 investigative reporter Matt Grant talking with the owner to get answers.
Brandon Huber. I'm an employee at the Golden Corral.
It's the YouTube video that's been seen more than 250,000 times.
Apparently, what my company likes to do to get ready for inspections is put their food by the dumpsters.
22-year-old Brandon Huber, a cook at this Port Orange Golden Corral, posted this video.
It's hamburger meat. Look at all these flies. It's disgusting.
Showing hamburger patties and other food items stored next to a dumpster. Golden Corral confirms this video was shot during a corporate inspection a little over a week ago.
Can you ensure customers that something like this will never happen again?
Well, it won't happen again under my watch.
The restaurant's owner, Eric Holmes, says it all started because a manager didn't want inspectors to see the food. He says that manager's since been fired.
Why didn't he want it inspected?
Because it was being thawed improperly and not by procedure.
Holmes tells us the food was improperly handled.
Green bean casserole, all your patty melts, your pot roast meat.
According to Holmes, surveillance video captured the whole thing on camera and the food was never served to customers.
Once we found out immediately what had happened and we threw all the product away.
We pulled the state inspection records and found since 2012 the restaurant's been cited 16 times for everything from minor violations up to critical ones.
In 2012, the restaurant received 4 critical violations for improper food temperature, leading to potentially hazardous food. Other violations include employees not washing hands and no proof of employee training. According to Golden Corral, Huber's father offered to sell them the video on eBay for $5,000. The restaurant refused, and the video was posted on YouTube. Huber is currently on paid administrative leave. Matt Grant, WESH 2 News.